Problem-based learning is just one component to Kenosha Unified's summer school program. It benefits students by allowing them a voice and a choice.
Problem-based learning is a different way to teach. It's a way to take all the content that the teacher wants the kids to learn, but it's sort of packaged in a problem that gets kids really engaged and they can see the application in real life.
The students could work on a gardening unit, a nutrition unit, healthy living, budget, sky's the limit.
Our problem is healthy living in our community, and our students have to figure out how we can incorporate and teach others how to live a healthy lifestyle.
We got into groups and I picked nutrition groups, and we're learning like which calories we're supposed to eat or like which calories we're not supposed to eat.
Like we're trying to get more people to have like fitness and more people to have like lose weight and more, like we little kids stop eating all the junk food.
We discovered that people are unhealthy, they have a lack of diet, and need to start exercising more.
We're doing this thing on a fantasy basketball player. His name is Timurutu, and he's from Finland, and he doesn't know how to change his stocks because he's going to the U.S. and to play for the Bucks.
Timurutu doesn't know how to spend his money, and he's looking for a house and insurance and benefits.
It really is a life skill to be able to address a problem, know how to approach it through the research, multiple solutions, and in the end, what's really clever is that every student's project can look different.
If we want kids to be a part of it, we have to make it fun.
This challenging approach to learning is truly student-centered. They discover the solution.
It helps you to be flexible. Perfect. What else?
We learn a lot about health benefits and that if you're a basketball player, you get a doctor, and then if you leave that team, you have to find your own.
So we bought him a condo and everything, and he's just living large, and then we bought him a Corvette. And usually everybody goes for the nicest sports car, but you gotta remember, you're wasting money. And if you waste money, you're gonna end up having none. It's gonna end up making you go bankrupt. And we have $10,000 left, so we're gonna be able to use that and like mortgage or something.
How many of you bought Apple?
Throw a hand up if you bought Apple.
No. What's happened to Apple in the last week?
It's gone down.
We did this big dance routine and encouraged people to dance and exercise more.
And then you're going to do it again where it's outside in. It almost looks like I'm ready to box.
We are trying to learn how to shop, learn how to cook healthy, less calories. We want to show them like some of the healthy stuff is kind of good.
For parents, they want to know that their children are following the district's high standards.
Math, science, social studies, all of the content can be delivered through problem-based learning. Teachers are very careful about what learning objectives that they put into a unit.
We're bringing into the classroom the soft skills, the things like collaborative learning, building relationships, being able to speak in front of a group, all of the things that they're teaching at home, they can apply in our classroom.
Parents should definitely embrace problem-based learning because it makes kids accountable. And I think that's an important skill that you need your entire life. Whether in school, outside of school, at home, they're figuring out what they need to do and how they need to get it done.
While curriculum is important, parents also want to know that their children are having fun.
I'm actually having a lot of fun here. We get to pick what we learn instead of the teachers tell us what to learn.
Well, it's really fun and we're working in groups and about computers more.
It's so much fun that I can't even put it in words. Helping other people starting to dance, that's a good feeling inside you.
It's actually really fun because we're actually helping the community get better, start exercising, and get healthy.
Get that stirred up really good.
Teachers train in the development of problem-based learning. In turn, teachers then incorporate problem-based learning into their summer school programs.
It's a little different teaching the teachers about problem-based learning. It's sort of repackaging the material and presenting it to the kids in a new way. It's actually a really nice chance for teachers to reflect on some of the fun parts of being a teacher.
I got to work really closely with my peers, my coworkers, and my colleagues. And most of all, it was rewarding to see the kids learning and discovering new things.
Kenosha Unified School District's teachers embrace problem-based learning.
I had a student, and the first day he took charge and figured tons of stuff out that other kids were just puzzled with. So it was really exciting to see some of our quieter students who tend to struggle really excelling in this setting.
One of the reasons I like it is the excitement in the students. It's energizing. I want to come to class too. I want to see what they're going to discover. It's no longer about me and what I have to share with them. It's about let's learn together.
Ultimately, the students are able to take what they learn and apply it to real-life solutions through a multimedia presentation to their class, parents, and teachers. Kenosha Unified School District, maximizing the brilliance of children.